Good Saturday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen, Onek. We've got a quiet evening after a few thunderstorms boiled away. There's not much left of them at this time, but we may see the possibility of more thunderstorms into later on tonight and quite possibly into tomorrow. Doesn't look like anything widespread severe weather, so good news on that, but it is going to be another steamy one out there. We've still got about another hour to go before the heat advisory expires for most of the Mid-South area for tonight, as those temperatures remain back mainly into about the upper 80s to lower 90s. We'll take a look at live real-time WeatherNet 3 coming up here in just a little bit. We'll also take a look at some more of your weather pictures coming up. Hopefully you're watching this netcast from someplace cool, because you're going to be needing that in spades over the course of the next several days, because we've got a lot of hot weather coming on through. Again, it's going to be pretty typical for this time of the year, but we've got the possibility of some shall we say, slightly less hot weather. Cool just really doesn't seem to cut it anymore. We'll talk about that coming up here in just a little bit. Thanks, everybody, for checking in so far from this evening. No matter where you're checking in, give us a location. Your city, your state will do nicely. Whole mailing address, not necessary, but thank you for trusting us with that. Those of you who have sent that in before. City, state, and if you've got a weather report, we'd love to see what's going on in your neck of the woods, whether that's in the Mid-South area, which again is North Mississippi, West Tennessee, and Eastern Arkansas. And again, if you're outside of that, no matter where you are, welcome to the show, and thanks for joining us. This is our online video weather blog called Weather Overtime. If you've never been here before, forecast at the bottom of your screen in the red bar, 7-day forecast there, all available at WREG.com/weather if you'd like to see a little bit more about what's going on there. So everybody keep cool, stick around for some great stuff to talk about with the weather, and hopefully this cools you off at least a little bit, because we've got more than a lot of summer to actually go through at this point in time. Go ahead and drag the autumn countdown clock out of the graphics closet and start the countdown as we go through the hottest portions of the summer coming up in the next few weeks. Autumn officially begins Saturday, September 22nd, and as of right now, we've got just about a little bit over 70 days and change before we actually change seasons over again. Not to guarantee any cooler weather, because once again, remember, we can still easily get into the 90s as we go through late September, even into early October. Yes, I know, I'm just totally full of good news for tonight. Rest of the evening, again, temperatures may be falling a little bit, but by the time we hit daybreak tomorrow, they're not going to be that low. Temperatures in the upper 70s to lower 80s, and that's going to be about as good as it gets into the area coming up into tomorrow. So if you're looking for any relief from the heat, not happening at this point in time, so upper 70s will be about as good as it gets into very early tomorrow morning. So don't think we're going to be getting, again, too much cooler out there, so definitely want to plan ahead for another hot Sunday coming up. Official high temperature today, 96, about 4 above average for this time of the year, 5 above the normal low temperature in Memphis for the National Weather Service Weather Almanac here. Again, no rainfall reported from earlier today. We are still ahead by about 5, almost 6 inches, so that's good news for the rest of the month and into August if we don't get that much. We're entering kind of the drier period of the year. November is one of our rainier months, and that is several months away, so it's difficult to say if we're going to get anything really huge between now and then. Still tropical storm season, and we'll take a look at that information coming up here in just a little while. Squawk 1111's webcam from around Olive Branch, Mississippi, sunset over toward the lower right-hand corner of your screen, and some very nice pastel colors from Olive Branch, Mississippi for tonight from the Weather Underground camera network. From Shelby Farms camera, sunset in progress, looking across Hyde Lake and across Farm Road. A few clouds drifting on through, making for that nice colored schematic there for tonight. And a beautiful view from our Hilton East Memphis camera, looking toward the towers of East Memphis around Poplar and Mendenhall. Winds out of the southwest tonight, flying nicely, but also escorting in a lot of very moisture-rich air, so we're just not going to be seeing too much of any help with the winds bringing in any cooler weather, which would be nice to have them coming out of this direction instead. Not going to be happening anytime soon. Welcome to everybody here. Sheila Babbitt Meeks, hot summer of 1980. That was a scorcher back up in Kansas as well. John Michael, hope to see a high chance of rain soon. We'll talk about that potential coming up here in just a little bit. Wyatt, Mississippi, Alice McGowey, hot, hot, hot. Great song by Buster Poindexter as well. Hello from Tucson, Arizona, Peggy McDaniel. Welcome to the show. Georgetown, South Carolina, a little bit out of town, from Queen Victoria, Collington. Welcome to the show, Your Majesty. Thanks for dropping on through. And everybody else checking in, Campbell, Ohio, Hot 92, Monica Russell. Thank you very much for that one. And everyone else checking in, Clinton, Mississippi, raining, Sue Birdwell. Well, at least somebody's getting at least a little bit of relief into there for right now. Good news on that. We're looking at a lot more in the way of showers and thunderstorms well back to our north and west over portions of Missouri, back up around I-44 for tonight, and a lot going into the St. Louis metro area around Rolla, back toward I-55. All that is moving away from us as the winds out of the southwest taking those thunderstorms well to the north of the mid-south area. We did have some pulse thunderstorms popping up from time to time, and we may still see some thunderstorms in and around the area for the rest of the evening. The main thing that's going to be sticking around is naturally the heat and humidity, so that's going to be about as good as we can see. Still in the 90s around Blytheville at the airport and also around St. Francis in Cordova, everybody else in the upper 80s. And heat index temperatures, even as the sun sinks below the horizon, it's already cooked the lower atmosphere and the surface of the earth, so all that heat is still sticking around. And heat index temperatures, when you combine the temperature and the humidity to get the heat index, still feels like it's over 100 degrees out there, so it's going to be, again, some pretty dicey conditions out there for doing anything in the way of lots of exercise or work. So please make certain you pace yourselves out there. And also make certain your pets have plenty of water, too. They're wearing the fur coat. You're not. So, again, make certain they have adequate shelter and cool places to go to out there. 84.4, that's specific. Thank you very much. Joyce Johnson Berry from Crenshaw, Mississippi. And no wind to talk about. I believe that. Very not breezy out there. Winds about 5 miles per hour or less. Through about News Channel 3 at 10. Back into the mid to upper 80s at best throughout the evening hours, and there will be that chance of showers and thunderstorms sticking around from time to time. We're just not going to see that go anyplace. Again, a random thunderstorm, develop, drift, collapse, start all over again. They could get a little bit on the stronger side, but there's no widespread severe weather threat, so definitely some good news there. Unfortunately, tomorrow temperatures go upwards very quickly, and we're going to wind up once again easily back in the at least the mid-90s. I think some of these numbers are a little bit overblown by the computer, taking into account the humidity and the southwesterly winds. If we get enough cloud cover out there tomorrow, if that kind of shades things by just a little bit, more than likely going to be seeing mid-90s. There will be some upper 90s, yes, but I don't think we're going to be seeing triple digits from what it looks like. It's just too cloudy out there for right now, taking just that much edge off the heat so we don't get that hot. But at some point in time, hot is hot is hot, so it's going to be pretty steamy out there through about Sunday evening. By the time everybody heads back to work on Monday morning, lows not that low, again, upper 70s to lower 80s, and winds mainly variable, but starting to come back out of the southwest and keeping things, again, decently quiet for the time being. But into the next few days, this is where we shall see the dip in temperatures, sort of. We'll talk about that in just a second. Through the rest of tomorrow, again, mid to upper 90s, and that chance of showers and thunderstorms throughout the rest of the day tomorrow through Sunday night, right on in through Monday. So if you have outdoor plans, that golf game, kids taking them on a picnic at the park, getting the grocery shopping done, whatever it is, remember, if you can see lightning or hear thunder, you are within range of getting struck by lightning. And yes, just because you hear thunder, that means lightning is within a certain radius and you can hear it, and that means you are within range of getting struck by lightning. So again, play it safe, back indoors again. Let's make certain everybody stays safe through the summer season as we head on through here. Vera Davis, it's July. It's supposed to be hot, right? Yes, that is definitely the case, but if I just told everybody it was hot and signed back off here, I wouldn't have any fun doing my job whatsoever, and you wouldn't be able to hear my melodious voice. So again, we can help each other out on this for right now. Temperatures, again, dropping by just a little bit. We'll be back in the lower 90s. This is normal for this area of the country at this time of the year. There will be those chances of showers and thunderstorms out there. Lows going back into the lower to mid 70s. Not exactly comfortable, but not exactly the 80s either. So we'll get kind of a dip in the temperatures. Really hesitate to call it quote-unquote cooler, but again, let's just go for less hot. Maybe that'll work for the next couple of days. Unfortunately, as we head into next weekend, if everything holds over the next 10 days, we're going to head back upwards on the temperatures into the mid-90s as we head toward the later part of July and going into August. It looks like a pretty steamy conditions out there. Now, so far, looking good on the chances of showers and thunderstorms. Doesn't look like that much through next weekend and into the last full week of July. Now, going again into the next several days after that, the extended forecast does have some pretty steamy conditions out there according to the Climate Prediction Center, and not much in the chance of rainfall if, again, everything holds. We'll keep you updated on that as we go throughout the course of the next several days out there. Thanks to everybody for the kind comments, and we'll give you again an idea as to what's going on with the forecast as we go into tonight on News Channel 3 at 10 as well. Tropical air across the Mid-South, no questions about that. Beryl is now just a, well, it's now a tropical storm again. Technically, it's a post-tropical storm back out over the Atlantic. It's well away from the Mid-South area. There's nothing going on in the Gulf or the Caribbean redeveloping at this time, according to the National Hurricane Center. Now, what's going to happen with Beryl? Well, as a tropical depression, now a tropical storm, it looks like it's going to go for a tropical storm for a while before it becomes a tropical depression again, heading up into the cooler waters of the Northwest Atlantic around the Canadian Maritimes. So that's going to give a kind of a kibosh on the possibility of getting more thunderstorms out of this, and no threat to the United States, so good news on that. Likewise, we do not have anything else happening in the North Atlantic. We've got high pressure doing a pretty good job here, and that high pressure is keeping things pretty stable, but it's also bringing dust in off the Sahara again, and a lot of that is going to do, again, a good job of kind of squashing any possibility of any tropical storm by blocking the sunlight and keeping things a little bit more stable down this direction where these hurricanes usually form. So that's good news, but again, this is just the opening month or two of hurricane season, so we need to watch what goes on out there. Over the next several days and weeks, we'll be getting more and more potential as the ocean waters warm back up again, so stay tuned to News Channel 3 for updates. We'll keep you advised as to what's going on, if anything's heading our way. RWY Jr., some very kind words out there. Didn't pay attention apparently to the forecast and had his sprinklers running at the same time he had a nice downpour going on. So always pays to go local if at all possible instead of from some national app. So thank you very much for the kind words on that. Kelvin Gates taking a look on the Mississippi from a few years ago. Nice little summer shot from the Island Queen, disembarking some passengers there on a nice summer day. And a nice view from earlier this week from Cubs, Tigers, Grizz. A beautiful view of the Peabody rooftop from their Thursday night parties up that direction. Beautiful view looking back to the west over downtown Memphis, and a lot of people having some fun out that direction. So thank you very much for that one. You've got pictures. We'd love to see them, but we can't show them to everybody unless you send them. So tweet them to me, Aonic_WREG3. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Facebook. I'm on numerous other places as well. Or if you just want to skip all that, you can email it to me again at austin.onek@wreg.com, and would love to have you around from there as well. Amy Hayes in, I'm assuming that's St. Louis, pop-up showers and thunderstorms there. Hope the wasn't a problem for the reopening of the Gateway Arch Park. I heard some good things about that. Sounds like that's going to be a neat place to revisit once again. Thank you very much for checking on through. Hot Springs National Park, David Fitzgerald Bryant Sr., welcome to the show. A little bit of rain around Hot Springs for this evening. Thank you very much for that one. Let's see, just turn the thermostat down so it's cooler, please, Brian Brooks. Nice sentiment. If I ruled the world, every day would be the first day of spring, but unfortunately it doesn't work that way. But thank you for thinking of me on that. And thanks to everybody else for checking on through into and around the Mid-South for, and also beyond the Mid-South as well. Thanks for stopping on by. If you can't be near your computer, your tablet, or anything else, check out the forecast on the radio, East Arkansas Broadcast Network stations, Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. My forecast on throughout the rest of the weekend. And, of course, we'll have more on the forecast, including a look at weather where the troops are. If you have friends or loved ones stationed in the United States military around the globe, we'll take a look at some of the sites, at what's going on, and give you an idea as to how you can stay tuned to weather while your family members or friends or loved ones are deployed overseas. So if you'd like to know more about that, tune in just about 15 minutes on my Facebook, Twitter, and Periscope pages, and we'll have more on that coming up here in just a little while. That'll do it for this edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. Again, any questions or concerns or something on here that you would like to see, please email me again at austen.onek@wreg.com, and stay tuned for more. Kristen Holloway will have more coming up on News Channel 3 at 10 for the news. Megan Rice will have sports, yours truly with weather, and that'll be coming up here in just about 90 minutes, so stay tuned for a full update there. Also available, again, at wreg.com/weather. Thanks for joining us tonight. Stay tuned to News Channel 3 throughout the rest of the weekend for updates on all the day's news, weather, and sports.